here with a new review. Today I will be doing the Marvel Legends House of M series. It's a very good series, from what I hear.
Okay, enough with the megaphone. Finally got it working again, so I had to try it out. I'll be doing the Marvel Legends House of M figures. Now, I'm not going to do a whole review of the story, because, one, I haven't even read the story yet. I have it downloaded, but I haven't read the stories that led up to it, like Avengers Disassembled and, I think, Planet X. Why am I doing a Marvel Legends? Because there's a user on here that's been asking me for a good 2 months when I was going to do more Marvel Legends reviews. And I've had these guys, and I've actually had the review filmed a good 3 times, and each time I didn't like it because I didn't cover what the House of M was. That could be a problem because I've never read House of M. But basically what happens is Wanda Maximoff, I'm going to pronounce her name wrong, created this world where pretty much everyone, it was like the perfect world somewhat. She had 2 twins born to her. Magneto ruled over Genosha, and he had the House of M, the House of Magnus. It had Magneto, Quicksilver, Scarlet Witch, and I want to say there's one other person, but I don't know. I haven't read the bio on Wikipedia in a while. And pretty much it was a perfect world. Wolverine was the leader of S.H.I.E.L.D. He was with Mystique. Doctor Strange was a psychologist, I believe, and it's basically just the perfect world. Everybody's happy. Everybody's so happy. Peter Parker's married to Gwen Stacy. That kind of happy. Problem is, though, is that nobody remembers the other world. Scarlet Witch created this world herself using her magic powers and everything. The only person who remembers is Wolverine. And a buddy of mine actually told me that the reason he remembers is because, for once, Wolverine is happy. And he knows he can never truly be happy. So he remembers everything, the other world. Him, and then he goes on this Wizard of Oz tale, gets other heroes. They find a little girl who has abilities that she can see alternate realities. She remembers the other world, and she can show it to others. So she shows it to, like, Luke Cage and all these heroes. And they're like, well, we're gonna change things. So they go to stop Wanda, and basically a big battle ensues. And then, seeing all this fighting, I think Quicksilver almost dies at some point by Magneto, I think. Scarlet Witch is like, we're all freaks, mutants, whatever. Fine, no more mutants. World changes again. The mutant population goes down from the millions to the hundreds. The same buddy, he's a big comic geek. He's huge. Not huge as in big, but huge as in knowledge-wise. He said it's pretty much the scene where you see Iceman, and he's covered in water because his powers just quit on him like that. There's, students who can fly, and their powers go away, and they crash to the Earth. I think Wolverine has knowledge over his entire life, and it kind of messes with him. And there's a lot of mutants that are missing. And it's drastically changed the Marvel Universe from what I understand. And I think later on there's going to be the Secret Invasion, I think, the storyline. Or around that, it's going to cover what the Skrulls were doing during the House of M reality. And then there's going to be a Civil War House of M that showed how Magneto gained his power. It's a very big series, and I would love to read it sometime. But I'm doing the figure set. The only figure set of House of M, and I really wish that, I wonder often, if Toy Biz had stayed with the Marvel Legends line, would we have more sets like these? Because here we have the House of M. It's got, oh crap, I forget his name all of a sudden, and I just closed the page, but it's got the Inhuman Torch, who I believe is the adoptive son of Victor Von Doom. We have the Hulk, Iron Man, and It, or The It. This is a kind of odd set to put together, I think, being that the Inhuman Torch and the It are part of the Fearsome Four, Victor Von Doom's team. The Hulk, all I can find in him is that he went to Australia, met this tribe, befriended them, they told him how to control his powers, people came to attack the tribe, he defended him, and he's now the ruler of Australia. That's all I could find about him during the House of M. Tony Stark, acquired the property of the contracts to build the Sentinels, from what I've read. And I'm probably way wrong, but go figure. I'm a comic geek who doesn't read comics that often. And this is his new armor that he's been building. Alright, so, enough of that. I guess I'm going to do the two members of the Fearsome Four first. So get you guys out of the way. Iron Man likes to fall over because he's really heavy. Yep, oh, there he went. He almost went down. Okay, so the Fearsome Four is basically Victor Von Doom's team. From what I read, because I'm going off knowledge that I've read months ago, and if I can remember it, great. If not, oh well, tough gazoongas. Victor Von Doom came across a crash shuttle that had the bodies, had the dead bodies of Reed Richards, Sue Storm, Johnny Storm, and a barely alive Ben Grimm. And I'm guessing this is after they had gotten their powers, after the cosmic rays had hit them. The ship had crashed. Ben Grimm was a rock, so he survived pretty well. Victor Von Doom used his magic to copy the abilities of the other three. And I think this is Adoptive Son. I want to look it up, but I can't record video and go on the Firefox at the same time. My laptop spazzes out and curses at me, basically. But gave him the powers of Johnny Storm and turned him into the Inhuman Torch, which is very cool looking. He used his wife. He gave her the powers, basically, of, I believe, Sue Storm. And she became I'll put it right down there and show what it was, because I can't remember. And Doom himself gave him the abilities of Reed Richards, and he can make this organic metal that could stretch like rubber all over his entire body. So it's Doom and Richards if they had a kid, which makes no sense at all, but there you go. And then you have Ben Grimm, who, unless he's out with the team, he's locked in a cage. Alright, so each figure comes with its own little base, House of M. They use the same thing for the Young Avengers set, which I will review at another time. They're a pretty cool set also. Here we have the It. Ben Grimm. He is obviously not happy. I mean, he's kept in a cage, unless he's out fighting with Doom. He has a collar around his neck, which I think is pretty cool. It's just a very sad expression for Ben. I mean, you really feel sorry for the guy. If you felt sorry for him before, just look at him now. Articulation-wise, these guys are pretty much on par with the other Marvel Legends. Head, I think you can look up and down. I'm sorry. Look up and down slightly. He can spin all the way around. He can break his neck. Which, I really see no point in the full 360-degree rotation for the head. I've never really cared for that. If a figure doesn't have that, great. Nobody can turn their head that far unless they're a Transformer. When do they really do it? The arms have full movement all the way around, although he does get rather tight back there. He has a little swivel for his arm, he can turn it there. He has a joint in the elbow that looks like it either doesn't turn or is just extremely tight. Yeah, he has a joint in the elbow that apparently you can't really turn his elbow that much. He has a joint in his hand, so he can wave. His fingers have joints, and they actually have a joint at his knuckle as well, so he can... You can get a little grasping going, but it looks like they were painted, so you have to kind of force them at first, but there you go for his hand. And his thumb has a little joint right there. Waist, he can turn all the way around, which, again, is a pointless feature. The legs have movement. The knees have better movement than his elbows. His feet have good movement at the ankles, and he has little joints for his toes, sort of. So that's what it looks like when Ben Grimm bends a finger or a toe. He gets a big crack. Overall, it's a great figure. This is definitely a really great detailed one. You know, the rock around here has a lot of wear all over it. So some parts are here a lot darker, some are a lot lighter. He has a lot of dings and bumps all through it, and just the detail is really nice in this guy. I definitely like him. From what I hear, people think he is the best of the set, just by his detailing. And he's a really good figure. And put him back on this little peg, because while he does stand well on its own, I do not want to lose the stand. Because I have a tendency to lose things very easily. Of course, I am a college student, so my room isn't the best looking, but hey. Okay, well, I got 1 foot put in. Let's see if one foot didn't go back in. Okay, anyway. Stand! Stand! Stand, you beast! Okay, here we have the Inhuman Torch. One thing Toy Biz did, if you remember, I think I showed it in a past review, they have these little stands they include for some figures that are meant to fly. Or you could buy these on their own, so you can have, you know, the high kicking ability. Well, get this guy out for a second. They greatly improved their design with this set. The previous ones, the screws wouldn't go all the way, they would get stripped very easily, and there was no connector on this side, so the screw went in and would stop in the middle, and it was really bad stands. Well, these guys, they improved them so much. You can get full movements, it locks in place nicely. I really like the stand they used for these. I just wish they used more of it, because the other ones, I'm not explaining too well, I know. The other stands are basically cheap crap. These are really good, and they have a little mount in the back, so you can hang them on the wall and have them in a variety of poses. I leave him like that because I like having him as like a swooping in type action. So here we have the Inhuman Torch. His body is translucent, it's nice and orange. You can see through it really well. If I had my little flashlight, I could do a little see-through test, but I don't. You just have to kind of live with that. There you go. Detail on this guy is very nice. You can see his face. He is very scary. You don't want to invite him to the children's birthday parties. The wings are really nicely done, but one of them is really loose, and it doesn't like to stay up very well. You can get full move with the wings. Get him up, get him down, get him as if he's, you know, about to swoop in. Get him as if he's just gliding. Just going with it. Head has full movement, although it's, you know, don't care for it. Has a joint at the neck, you look up and down. His arms have full movement. All these guys basically have your standard Marvel Legends variety of posability. He has... I think he can turn his wrist, maybe, but it's kind of hard and I don't want to force it. Elbow has a double joint, and his legs are basically the same. He has a double joint for the knee. You can get him all swiveled around. Hip can go all the way. Woo! Ooh, look, let's go. Belly! Yay! And, leg, ankle, all that fun stuff. And then he has, you know, the four on his chest, because he is part of the Fearsome Four. Not Fearful Four, as I thought it was originally, and was kind of upset when Google had nothing on Fearful Four. So they tried to recommend me Fearful Four with an F-O-R. That's not what I want. I like to have him pose about like that, as if he's just, you know, just chilling, just hanging out. I know he's fire, he can't really chill, but still. Pretty cool figure, the set. I'm going to take him down. Going to take Ben down. And move on to the Hulk, which, like I said, the Wikipedia and Marvel site didn't really say much about the Hulk, as far as House of M goes. But I think he looks very, very nice. The paint application on him looks very good. It has a nice tribal design to it. And he's just a pissed off guy. I mean, look at him. The Hulk's meant to be mad. But he's a new level of mad here. He has about the same type stuff with it. Put on it real quick. The paint job on his arms here, they look really good, but they weren't done very well. I've actually lost some paint here from his arms from moving around. And kind of sad about that. I actually saved it hoping I could fix it, but I've lost it again. And... you know, I don't know. I wish they had done a better job at making sure that didn't happen. But regardless, this is a great figure. Arms have the same movement as the It. You can get him in a nice little type pose. Elbow has really good movement to it. He has the same fingers as It, except the knuckle is permanently stuck like that. You can't bend him anymore. But he's a Hulk. He uses his fist. He doesn't pick up things. So, okay. Waist is full. Ooh. Oh, I didn't know that. Hello. You can get a little clobbering smash going. I didn't know he had that. Woo! 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 Hey, Hulk. I hear the Karen was talking about your girl. Yeah, I mean, she kicked its little booty. And you wonder why my camera doesn't work anymore. Okay. The pants detailing, yes. Movement at his hip. He has a double joint in his knee. So you can get some pretty cool posability. His feet look really good. I mean, he has the same thing that the thing, the It, whatever has. Except he can do these really nifty little bends and turns and everything. And just the detailing's overall really nice. Oh, of course, the head. He can look up. He can look down. He can turn around. Just the detailing, I like it. I like, you can see all the veins all through here. I like his face. Just, you can't really see his eyes too, but they're just angry. He has just all these tattoos all over him that just really make the figure look great. Without the tattoos, it looks good. But the tattoos make the figure, in my opinion. His pants shredded, you can see his pockets. I like it. I think this is my favorite of the line, definitely. The only complaint is the little issue with the paint on his shoulders. And a cool little thing to point out is, you can see, you know, he's got a snake tattoo on his arm. He's got a snake. It's a snake. So then you have the Hulk. Take that away. Same stand. Here we have Iron Man, Tony Stark. He is a very big figure. Take him off his little stand here. Alright, so he's pretty much packed to the teeth with a variety of weapons. He has these huge jet thrusters on his back that you can remove, separate it, and then that's got the little ammo clip for his gun, which, okay. His gun can come off. It's a very nice gun. And this is basically the core of the figure. My one complaint is it doesn't do like most of the other Iron Man figures. His helmet cannot come off, so you cannot see Stark's face. I really wish you could, but, you know, oh well. He has movements at the shoulders. He has a joint for the elbow. Ooh, a double joint for the elbow. He can turn his hand, and I think his fingers actually do move, although they are kind of hard to force. And I think my screen's getting really blurry, so that's not good. There it goes. Okay. Same with the other arm, and his legs move at the hip, or the waist, the crotch, a double joint for his knee, so he can get some pretty cool little movements, although the bottom joint appears kind of stuck, so I don't want to force that. Ah, here, this one works, although it feels really loose. That's great. His toes and his ankle have the same thing as the others. I mean, he's got your standard Marvel Legends type movement. A really cool figure, and he has little doohickeys on his back. So he can get like a little, you know, type thing going. Let's see, this part. This can come off. I'm sorry, it can't come off. I thought it could, but it's glued in there. These sections are off originally when you get it. So you can have these off. Although apparently this one's really in there. And you can have him on Stark's back. So you can still have him using his huge gun, type sniper rifle weapon, without having the giant little jet thrusters on. So you can have that. But really, he just looks so much better with these on. One complaint, though, is that since he is so heavy, I mean, he's got a lot of weight on his back, it is kind of hard to get him stand because these guys are flimsy at the base. So they kind of walk, you know, wobble around and everything. And but regardless, it does fit him pretty well. He does sit nicely as long as you have him turned the right way. You have to kind of tinker with him to ensure that he's not going to lean over. I mean, if you have him lean the certain direction or have the base turned, he could definitely tilt over. So just kind of tinker with it, see what works best. But that is it. First Marvel Legends review in a while. Hopefully I'm going to have a lot more done. I'm considering on starting to get some DC Universe figures. I hear they've got Build-A-Figures in those, and I'm a sucker for the Build-A-Figures sets. And I'm considering on getting a Gundam model kit, perhaps, because they look pretty cool. So hopefully I'm able to branch out from just your Transformers again. I really haven't done much in a while, so we'll see how that goes. But that's it, guys. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed the review. Just a smidgen. You don't have to like it a lot. Just a smidgen. I'm done. Oh, I forgot to mention one thing. When you get the House of M collector's set, it comes with a pretty cool little book that I thought I actually had here. Is that it? No, that's Marvel Zombies. It's kind of like a bio book about the characters in the House of M set. It is kind of cool. It's a little handbook type guide to show you the different characters and how they are in the series. I've apparently lost mine, so it can't be that great. but it's a good little read. I would highly recommend the House of M series, even though I haven't read it, because honestly, it's changed the face of the Marvel Universe quite a bit. It's a really important story to future stories of Marvel, and I hear it's a really good read. All right, saying it again, that's it, I'm done. Thanks for watching. Hope you have a great day, guys. See you around.